Hi guys, this is your girl Hilda and I'm back again with another video, Kamakawa guys. And thank you so much for the support. If you're new to my channel, welcome and welcome back. And if you're not new and you've always been here, Manze, thank you so much. And we're really growing guys, and I'm really appreciating all the support and love from you guys. So today I wanted to talk about the benefits and compensation that employees should really get. And I thought this would be a nice topic to talk about. So here in Qatar, they didn't have a national wage until 2017. The people who were working here before 2017, they really were not having some like specific national wages. But after that, after some complaints, they set a wage of 750. That was before 2021 World Cup, not 2022 World Cup. But later on, when Adlisa came up and tried to fight for our rights, and now the maximum wage you should get for the basic salary is 1,000 riyals. This is to mean if you're getting your salary from, let's say, 2015, 18, your company should give you 1,000, even if you haven't worked or not. Yani, that's a basic salary of which they should give you. So guys, so sorry for how I hope I'm visible. I'm just outside and it's so hot guys. So guys, I'm right now at Doha City trying to take this video. I wanted to give you a nice view for how this place looks like. Yeah, so guarantees of benefits here in Qatar that employees should get. So in Qatar, it has 4 holidays and employees should get time off, known as public holidays. And once there's an holiday, employees should be given off that time. Or if you won't get on that day, later on your working days, you should be given a PH. And the other thing, after, as a normal PH, they should also add a 3 working day off, okay, just for compensation. Okay guys, the other thing, if you've worked for 1 year here in Qatar, you should be given a 3-week paid leave. And if you've worked for 5 years, you should be given a 4-week leave. This is mostly, sometimes you find before going vacation, this is what you call a vacation. And most of the people, when they go vacation, they always try to add them up. You find like you do for 2 years, then after 2 years, you go home for the 1 month and or 2 months that you had, okay? So you should go home and you should be given a paid leave before you leave. And the other thing, your company should also give you a round trip, a paid transport air ticket. But you should confirm with your company, because some company, they don't give both. Sometimes they say if you've worked 1 year, they will just give you 1 ticket. Or once you work for 3 years or 5 years, they will give you 2 tickets. So it varies. So you should try and confirm with your company. The other thing, sometimes you should get a health card. It is a must and mandatory for you to have a health card from your company. So you should try and do that. And then the compulsory benefits that, you know, you should have is always the salary, the housing, the transport. But sometimes you find some people work in a company, but they don't get accommodation or transportation. So it varies, okay? So you should confirm before coming into any company, okay guys? The other thing also, I should talk about, I think that's all. So guys, if you watched my previous video, you know I was talking about the sponsorship. So guys, please try and if you really have the what is it called if you really have all that is required for you for the scholarship, please try and apply. It's really good for you. And if you're not, I'm so sorry, guys. But anyway, I love you all. And before you leave from this channel, please subscribe, like, and leave a comment below. Manze, I love you all, and thank you for the support. Okay, so take care. Love you all. Bye.